गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाइन स्टैंडर्ड सोशल साइंस हिस्ट्री यूनिट टू एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशंस। प्रीवियस लेसन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द प्री हिस्टोरिक पीरियड, नाउ यूनिट टू एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशंस। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स: टू लर्न अबाउट अर्ली सोसाइटीज एंड द स्टेट फॉर्मेशंस, टू अंडरस्टैंड द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ सिविलाइजेशंस, द एंशियंट इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशंस, मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशंस, चाइनीज सिविलाइजेशंस, and to gain knowledge about the Indus civilization. Introduction of the lesson. Societies that adopted complex way of life were more organized than the early hunter-gatherer and Neolithic farming societies. Urban societies had social stratification and well-planned cities. They practiced crafts, engaged in trade and exchange, adopted science and technology, and formed political organization. Hence, the term civilization is used to distinguish them from the early forms of societies. Ancient civilizations. Here, civilization means an advanced, organized way of life. It instilled a way of life that could be considered as an adaptation to particular environmental and cultural context. When it became necessary for large numbers of people to live in close proximity, they brought in planning, organization, and specialization. Settlements were planned and laid out. A polity emerged. Society became organized, and food production and craft production were regulated. As civilizations began to take shape, huge buildings were built. The art of writing developed, and science and technology contributed to the betterment of society. Now look at this map. This is a early world civilizations: Egyptian civilization in Africa, Mesopotamia civilization, Indus Valley civilization, and Chinese civilization. South India witnessed the emergence of Neolithic agro-pastoral communities and microlithic form of life by hunter-gatherers. Now we'll see about the Egyptian civilizations. As one of the oldest civilizations, the Egyptian civilization is known for its monumental architecture, agriculture, arts, sciences, and crafts as a very early age. Look at the Africa map. Egypt lies in the northeastern corner of the African continent. It is bounded by the Red Sea on the east and the Mediterranean Sea in the north. Egypt is irrigated by the river Nile. The Egyptian civilization depended solely upon the flow of Nile River, and hence Egypt was called the Gift of Nile by the Greek historian Herodotus. The Nile also served as a means of transport. The Nile Valley is very rich and fertile, as the river deposits fresh alluvium every year. This alluvium nurtured agriculture and helped to produce surplus of food grains, leading to the development of Egyptian civilization. Egypt became ultimately connected with the Sangam Age Tamilagam by the sea route. The Hyksos was where the rulers of 15th dynasty of Egypt, and they were probably from West Asia. Persians are the people from the region of Persia, the ancient Iran. Greek refers to the language and people of modern day state of Greece in Europe. Rome refers to the ancient Roman Empire, which had as its capital the city of Rome in Italy. Pharaoh's society and administration. The Egyptian king was known as Pharaoh. The people treated Pharaoh as a divine form. Under the Pharaoh, there was a hierarchy of officials, including viziers, the governors of provinces, local mayors, and tax collectors. The entire social system was supported by the work and production of artisans, including stonecutters, masons, potters, carpenters, coppersmiths, and goldsmiths, peasants, and workers. Land belonged to the king and was assigned to the officials. Slavery was not common, but captives were used as slaves. Viziers were the high officials who administered territories under the direction of the pharaohs. Now we'll see about the mummification. The Egyptians believed in life after death. Therefore, they preserved the dead body. The art of preserving the dead body is known as mummification. Pyramids and tombs were built to preserve the body of pharaohs. The famous Egyptian pharaohs, Tutankhamun, who ruled from 1332 to 1322 BC. Tomb with a rich variety of offerings is located near Luxor in Egypt. The mask of his mummy, made of gold and decorated with precious stones, is an important artifact of the Egyptian civilization. Look at this mask of Tutankhamun and mummified body of Tutankhamun. Mummies of Egypt. The preserved dead body is called the mummy. The Egyptians had the tradition of preserving the dead bodies using natron salt, a combination of sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate. The preservation process is called mummification. After 40 days, when the salt absorbed all the moisture, the body was filled with sawdust and wrapped with strips of linen cloth and covered with a fabric. The body was stored in a stone coffin called sarcophagus. Now let us see the small video of process of mummification.
This is a mummy of a young man named Heraclides. He died in Egypt in the 1st century AD when he was about 20 years old. Mummification was developed by the ancient Egyptians to preserve the body for the afterlife. Typically, all internal organs were removed before mummification, with the exception of the heart. But in this case, the heart was removed and the lungs were left intact. Next, the body was covered with salt and left for about 40 days until all moisture was eliminated. Perfumed oils and plant resins were rubbed on the body. Thick layers of resin were applied to glue the strips of linen that were wrapped around the body. The mummy was placed on a wooden board, and more wrappings bound them together. A mysterious pouch, perhaps of religious significance, was placed on the chest. A mummified ibis, a wading bird with a slender, down-curved bill, was placed on the abdomen. Ibis mummies commonly served as votive offerings to the gods, but this is an unusual case of a bird being mummified with a deceased human. Long linen strips further secured the wrappings. A portrait panel of Heraclides was placed over the face. A large linen cloth was wrapped around the mummy. The shroud was painted red with an imported lead-based pigment. This treatment is rare. Very few red shroud mummies are known to exist. Egyptian symbols of protection and rebirth were painted on the outer cloth with pigments and gold. Finally, Heraclides' name was written in Greek at the feet. Thanks to this remarkable mummification process, Heraclides' body is with us today.
Agriculture and trade. The Egyptians cultivated wheat, barley, millets, vegetables, fruits, papyrus, and cotton. The word paper comes from papyrus. The Egyptians wrote on the leaves of a plant called papyrus, a kind of reed which grew on the banks of Nile. Papyrus was used to make rope mats, sandals, and later for producing paper. They domesticated cattle, sheep, goat, and pigs, and hunted wild animals. They had pets such as dogs, cats, and monkeys. The Egyptians had trade relations with Lebanon, Crete, and Phoenicia, Palestine, and Syria. Gold, silver, and ivory were imported, and they acquired the lapis lazuli, a precious stone of bluish color, from Afghanistan. Look at this map. This is a river Nile. So near the river Nile, the cities of Egyptian civilization taken place. These are the settlements and tombs and the Sphinx, the great pyramid of Giza. Everything is situated in the side of the river Nile. Then the plowing farmer, 1200 BC. A depiction of grain harvest. The Egyptians excelled in art and architecture. Their writing is also a form of art. Numerous sculptures, paintings, and carvings attest to the artistic skills of Egyptians. The pyramids are massive monuments built as tombs of mourning to the pharaohs. The great pyramids near Cairo are known as the Giza pyramids. The Great Sphinx of Giza is a massive limestone image of a lion with a human head. It is dated to the time of Pharaoh Khafre. It is one of the largest sculptures of the world and measures 73 meters in length and 20 meters in height. Look at this, the Great Pyramid of Giza and view of Sphinx with the Great Pyramid, Egypt. Then religion. The Egyptians practiced polytheism. Amun, Re, Seth, Thoth, Horus and Anubis are some of the gods of Egyptians. Amun, Seth, Thoth, statue of Horus and Anubis. They worshipped many gods, but the sun god Re was a predominant one. Later on, the sun god was called Amun. Philosophy, science and literature. The Egyptian civilization excelled in science, literature, philosophy, astronomy, mathematics and measurement system. Sundial, water clock and glass were developed by the Egyptians. They devised a solar calendar that consisted of 12 months of 30 days each, with 5 days added to the end of a year. This calendar was introduced as early as 4200 BC. Literary works included treatises on mathematics, astronomy, medicine, magic and religion. The Egyptians also distinguished themselves in painting, art, sculpture, pottery, music and weaving. Then writing system of Egyptians. The Egyptians are well known for their writing system. Their form of writing is known as hieroglyphic. Hieroglyphic was used in the inscriptions on seals and other objects. The hectic, the heretic and another form of writing was used for common purposes. This form of writing used a pictogram-based system. It was developed around 3000 BC and many texts and books were written using this script. Now this inscription is on display in the British Museum, London. Look at this hieroglyphic script on the Rosetta Stone. Then characteristics and contributions of the Egyptian civilization. The Egyptians developed a solar calendar system. The pyramids and their designs show their mathematical and surveying skills. Hieroglyphic writing system attests to their skills in handling symbols. Preservation of human body in the form of mummies. They applied innovation in the use of science and technology.